2014 marks the first year of the sixth generation of the Porsche Turbo, 911 Turbo. This is one of the most iconic and fearsome cars in Porsche's lineup, and it has been since it was introduced back in the mid-1970s. It's an iconic car, and it's an important car to Porsche because prior to the car's introduction, Porsche really had a much different reputation. It started as a small car company and was known for being nimble and beating cars with agility, and then all of a sudden the Turbo appeared, and it was the most powerful car of its age, far more powerful than contemporary Corvettes, and I think it was more powerful than Ferraris of the age. But at the same time, it was also a feared car because it had a propensity for lift throttle oversteer, a turbo lag, and caused a lot of people to crash pretty badly. In the wrong hands, it could be a difficult car. The first of the 930s is one of the most memorable Porsches of all time. The slant nose looks bitchin', the rear end with the whale tail is really badass, and everything about the car says high performance. When you get in the car, it's a little bit of a different experience because, I mean, it seems like you've gone back, way back in time, into the Wayback Machine. The current 911 Turbo, which just comes out this year, the sixth generation, is a magnificent car. Awesome in all respects, 560-something horsepower, and just get outrageous speeds. But you have all these electronic controls on the car. There's so many things that the car does for you. This is good, it keeps you out of trouble, but on the other hand, you sort of feel a little bit removed from the car. So this second generation car is the second to the last of the aircraft. This car seems like the purest of the turbos. I mean, it's vast improvement over the first generation car, yet it's a little bit more direct. It looks spectacular. I mean, look at the rear end. How can you not love that car? The front end has sort of the classic 911 look from the early days. It's a car you can have a lot of fun with on the track, and you can enjoy it in everyday traffic. If we have to pick one car, that's what we want a car to do. Pretty much everything.